what's up everyone? So today I'm here to tell you, how do you know if you have depression? For those of you who don't know me, I suffered from depression since like 4 years ago. And since then I have had 3 major episodes. I've been through therapies, I'm currently still under medication. I'm not a medical healthcare like professional, but I'm just here to tell you what I've learned through my experience, okay? So if this is something that you're interested to watch, then keep on watching. I used to take like psychology 101 when I was in university, like first year of university. So I kind of know the symptoms of depression. I kind of know how it works, how it's like I have an idea of it. So when it first happened to me, it was just really easy to like, okay, I think something is wrong with me. It could be depression, but I'm not super sure. But you know what? I'm just gonna go see anyone. I'm just gonna go see someone and try to like talk about it and get it figured out. So that was how I find out. Now, for you, you might not be sure. You might have already like Googled what is depression and how is the symptoms like. The thing with depression, it's different for everyone. For some people, it will be a loss of appetite, but for some people, it could be they just couldn't help themselves but just keep eating and eating and eating and eating. I mean, that's just an example. For some people, it could be not having able to sleep at all or like have really bad quality sleep. But for me, I was sleeping all day, and even if I've like slept for 8 hours, I would still feel so extremely sleepy the day after. So the symptoms could differ from one to one, and like you might have crossed off certain things in the list of things of depression, but you know, you can't decide like if you are depressed or not. So one thing that could help you to, let's just say, decide if you need help, it's like to ask yourself this question: is it affecting your daily functionality? Okay, so are you sleeping so much to the point that you are skipping work just to sleep? Or like towards the point that it affects your relationship with your family and your friends? Are you skipping work? Are you not feeling like meeting your friends at all and you just stop meeting everyone? Has it caused you to like not do your laundry for weeks? Because that's what happened to me when I was extremely depressed. I remember at that phase last year, I just couldn't bring myself to clean up my place at all. I have like boxes of takeout boxes like laying right next to my bed. My laundry was like piling up. I think all I did was like washing my panties when I was showering so that I have more clothes to wear, but that was the only thing I did. Generally, from a medical perspective, if I'm not mistaken, to be officially diagnosed with depression, this kind of behavior has to last for around 2 weeks. Then that way they are able to, you know, start like, I think, prescribing you with therapies or medication and stuff like that. I believe the period is 2 weeks of like non-functioning behavior. And of course, besides this, another thing that could help you decide if you are depressed is perhaps suicidal thoughts and suicidal behavior. Have you been thinking like, you know, there's no point living? Or there's no point, you know, or maybe you have been researching about suicidal methods and, you know, thinking of swallowing extra pills. Like, if you are having these thoughts, perhaps it's time to get help. So what do you do if you know that you are depressed? The step is pretty simple. Just go to a normal family physician, like the doctors, the clinics that you can find anywhere in your area. go to the person that you would go to if you have a flu, if you have a cough, if you have a fever. Go to that person and tell that person that, you know, you have been acting really, like, really weirdly. You haven't been having any motivation to leave at all. You know, if you have, if you need to, you might need to be really honest that you're kind of suicidal because, you know, it's kind of urgent in a way that you need to see someone. So just talk to a normal doctor like that, and then this doctor should be able to prescribe you with a referral letter to go to your closest hospital or the psych department or like a psychologist or counselor, okay? I would say this is like the best first step to do. If you don't want to like tell your family about it, don't tell, like just go to the doctor. If you are really young and you have to have someone to take you to the doctor, then maybe call a suicide hotline, I would say. Like, I'm trying to picture myself, like a 15-year-old myself, trying to convince my mom that I'm depressed. Like, my Asian mom might be denying that. So I would say like try to call the suicide hotline or talk to like a teacher in school, someone that you can trust. I'm sure you'll be able to find help. Okay, don't give up. Don't give up on yourself and don't hate yourself. Depression is really scary. Back then I was in an episode, I really hated myself so much because I had no motivation whatsoever. And then I started having suicidal thoughts, and then I started hating myself for having these thoughts because I know my friends and family loves me and I'm like a nice person, but I just can't help having these thoughts, and I just hated myself even more. So it became a vicious cycle and it can be really scary, but you know, I've been through that and I'm here to share with you that, you know, it's just a phase and it could be a medical condition, but you will be fine. Okay, so let's just recap. How do you know if you're depressed? Step number one, go Google the symptoms on what depression is or like what kind of things, like loss of appetite or like bad quality sleep or good quality sleep, like all this basic stuff. And then step number two, ask yourself if this has been affecting your daily functionality. Like, has it been stopping you to perform well as a human being? Like, have you been skipping work or like not be productive at work at all towards the point that you are getting a red flag from your HR? Has it been affecting your relationship with your friends or your family? Have you been like, you know, just lashing it out at them for no reason? This could be it. And then if the answer for number two, if it's yes, then maybe step number three is to go seek help, whether it's calling the suicide hotline or go see a doctor, you know, just do it. So this is how you know you have depression, and I hope that you are doing fine, okay? You could be just feeling the blues, and it could be just a really temporary grieving period of like losing someone that you really love. It could be it, but it could also be depression. So think about it, and I hope that this video can be really helpful for you. Okay, if you have any questions, please feel free to drop a comment below and I'll try to assist you as much as I can, because I'm not a doctor, like I said, or I'm not any professional, but I've just been through it, and I really hope that you don't go through that, or even if you do, you know what to do. Okay? I hope that you stay strong, or this dark period, this dark clouds can get out of your mind as soon as possible, and you take care, alright? I'll see you in my video next week. Goodbye.